So we're here in Universal Studios, and there's a lot of themed rides, which that one is Despicable Me right over there with the Minions.
They have three.
And there's all kinds of gift shops along these areas here. You can also get restaurants that contain foods from all over the world here. And they have a lot of themed rides and games from the likes of the Minions, Despicable Me, as well as Shrek.
This is supposed to simulate the back lot.
And there's also Woody Woodpecker, Blue Man Group, The Simpsons, Harry Potter, and one of my personal favorites, SpongeBob SquarePants. They have a lot of those on display here. And there's a lot of gift shops where you can get merch as well. Not only is this Disney themed, but it's got Nickelodeon and Warner Brothers themed stuff. And it even has E.T. the Extraterrestrial as well. And there's the Simpsons ride and the Kids Zone on that directional thing right there. This is like a little Main Street area with all kinds of restaurants and bars and shops along here. And here I'm with my whole school group. We're having a lot of fun. There's a lot of really cool stuff to do here. All these games and rides and restaurants and attractions are all a lot of fun. Definitely gives me a reason wanting to come here. This is actually one of my favorite places in all of Orlando, Florida. Although, this place is not as big as Disney World, but it's still pretty big. It's got a decent amount of rides and games and attractions here. And also quite a bit of characters and all kinds of other stuff. And there's more buildings over there with more rides and attractions. And it even has a classic car drive-in restaurant with those classic muscle cars on display. That's pretty cool. That's right up my alley right there.
You see,
and here's more buildings along here.
He was kidnapped again.
And right over there, you can briefly see it, but there's a Transformers theme ride over there. If you're a Transformers fan, they got Optimus Prime and Megatron. And right up there is a roller coaster that goes straight up and straight down. It's insane. Forgot to mention that they have a lot of roller coasters here as well. This place is beautiful. It really is. It's also a lot of fun to see. There's a lot of sights to see. Wow, this is beautiful. Oh, here's a merch stand right up here. Oh, wow. Some pretty cool merch. And it looks like there's the Kid Zone over there for the Minis. It's got Woody Woodpecker over there. And right over there is one of my favorite places, the SpongeBob SquarePants gift shop, where you can get SpongeBob themed merch and even take a picture with SpongeBob as well. I really would hope to see that, and that is one of my favorite areas here. And right over there is an auditorium where you can see all kinds of shows. And look at that monster steam locomotive train. This one is from Back to the Future, the movie series. And there's Dr. Brown right there. And here's the original DeLorean from the movie as well, the time machine that I also filmed at a car meet that I was at with my dad once. And here's a food truck from Bumblebee Man of The Simpsons. And this is The Simpsons area right over here. As you can see, here is the Lard Lad Donut Dude. Krusty Burger. And there's Chief Wiggum and his police car. Duff Beer.
One sec, over by the boy.
And in that building is where the Simpsons Motion Ride is. So if you're a Simpsons fan, then you'll love this ride, definitely. And there's the Quickie Mart as well. And there's a cool alien spinning ride with the aliens King and Kodos. That thing lifts you up and spins you around. There's quite a few rides like that in parks like this. They're a lot of fun. It's called the Twirl and Hurl. That's kind of cute. And here's some Simpsons-themed games that you can play right along here. There's a little hot dog stand. And there's Bart, Lisa, and Homer and Marge in that little cart that you ride in. In the actual ride, there's a little basketball thing right over there. And a test your strength mallet hammer thing right over here where you pound down on that hammer and to see how high that the meter goes to test your strength. And there's another merch gift shop over there. And right over here is the Men in Black theme ride. What that is that it's a simulator where you sit in it and you shoot laser guns on it and you try and hit enemy targets and you score points with it. That's a lot of fun. And here, we're crossing a bridge. You can see a pretty decent amount of the park here. There's that roller coaster again. And there's a, this is a really big lake or a river. This is huge. And here's another view of it over here. Oh look, it's got a pontoon boat right over there. Here, right over there where you can eat. That's pretty cool. And it looks like we're approaching Hogsmeade of the Harry Potter part of the area. So if you're a Harry Potter fan, then you'll love this part of the park. And look at this monster right over here. That is the triple-decker night bus. For those of you who have seen the Prisoner of Azkaban movie, it's basically a modified double-decker with an extra deck on top. That thing is huge. And it also uses nitrous oxide to boost it and give it more speed. And here, we're approaching the Harry Potter world right in here. Whoa, look at this. Here we are in Hogsmeade. There's a little sweet shop right in here. Wow. These are some shops that are also seen in Diagon Alley in a lot of the Harry Potter themed movies as well. If you're a Harry Potter fan, then you'll recognize this area. It looks very familiar. And here's more of it over here. It's got a big dragon on the top of that building. There's Gringotts, the Wizard Bank, where the wizards get their money so they can buy all their wands and their gear. There's more buildings along here. It looks like this is the first attraction we'll be doing. So yeah, that's a pretty decent view of Universal Studios, and I'll be getting some more videos of this later on. So it turns out the Transformers ride is going to take a little bit of a wait. So now it looks like we're going to do this brand new Fast and Furious attraction that just recently came out. Now, my brother's girlfriend actually saw this and thought of me. And so, I've never actually seen this before, so this is brand new, it looks like. I don't know if it's going to be like an actual car race, or like a roller coaster, or a simulator, or whatnot. I'm not sure, but I'm looking forward to this, since I'm a huge fan of Fast and Furious, and all their custom cars they make. Dude, this is going to be fun. Oh yeah. Especially with Dom and Letty in the gang.
Oh, so guys, main entrance right over here, if you have express...
So this room has all the cars from the Fast and Furious franchise movies, including multiple versions of Dom's Charger, and it even has the Ford Escort that Paul Walker drove, and right over there you can see the WRX Impreza and Mazda RX-7 from Tokyo Drift. Yeah, this right here, this is the RX-7 that Han drove from Tokyo Drift, driven by Sung Kang. Wow, it's got that Veilside body kit. That is beautiful. There's the Charger and Escort. And there's the Subaru WRX Impreza. Man, these cars are awesome. They are highly customized and tricked out and ready to go racing and take all that abuse. They don't just build these cars for show, they actually drive them and trash them and abuse them. That's what they're all about. So this is called Toon Lagoon. There's a giant water slide right over here. Look at this, this is huge. Whoa! Double splasher right there, and it goes out to the other side right there.
Wow.
And there's more stuff right over here. Oh, they got caricature drawings right there, so they can make a caricature of yourself. That's pretty cool. Did it get more merch right here? Oh, there's a stadium right there. It says, "What's the motto, you?" That's kind of cute. And a snack shack right there. And here's where you can see the ride go down, like right here. You got a good view from here.
Yeah.
Wow. Got some more stuff that way. So now we're deciding what to do in this area. They may probably do that way. I'm gonna be staying right here with some friends of mine who may not want to do this as well, so we'll see what happens. Okay, so we're actually going to the Marvel area over there, but here's the rest of Toonland. That's a what's a Mata you thing, that's pretty cute. And that's called Gasoline Alley. I'm guessing that's a car-based type gift shop. It's pretty cool. And there's more shops over here. Wow. Pretty neat stuff down there. And more shacks and shops. Let's see. Oh, there's Comic Strip Cafe right there. Probably got some comic books there. Oh, another restaurant. That's cool. Wow. A lot of comic book themed stuff here. Oh, and a little playground for the minis. That's kind of cute. And there's a lot more merch shops in here. Oh look, there's an ice cream shop right there, that's pretty cool. And there's Comic Strip Cafe, that's probably another restaurant where you can eat at. Yeah, this Toonland's pretty cool. Photo Funnies, that's probably where you can get funny photos of yourself or stuff like that.
Oh my god,
and let's let's see, here's games over here that you can play.
Really?
And you could win merch from that. Oh, they even got the classic whack-a-mole. Everyone loves that game. There's even basketball. There's even some water shooters here. And if you get enough points, you could win some of those prizes of merch. There's basketball right there. And right now, we're approaching the marble area. This is where they have stuff like Spider-Man and the Hulk, Doctor Doom, and the Avengers. If you're a Marvel fan, then you'll know a lot about this. There's a comics area right there. Another ice cream shop. Wow, that's pretty cool. There's a big comic shop right there. And there's a diner right there where you can eat. And there's a vacation information thing right there. There's Captain America right there. Whoa, this is pretty big. Wow, it's got a crystal structure right there. Wow. And there's Spider-Man. It's one of the rides here.
Whoa.
Wow.
This is huge.
And there's a pretzel shop that you can get pretzels at. There's a lot more rides down there. Now we're gonna check out Spider-Man real quick and see what that's about. Get some more rides down there. There's another roller coaster right there. I'm guessing that one's probably gotta be the Hulk or something. There's an arcade where you can play video games. There's another restaurant right here. Whoa, that is a really tall coaster. It's got a lot of loops and turns and twists everywhere. Wow, and it goes up that ramp right there.
Are you kidding?
Oh, there's Fantastic Four right there.
Oh, it's the Hulk.
Yeah. Yep, that's the Hulk coaster right there. There it goes! Wow, that is one insane coaster. That is for sure. Not really one of my favorites, but it's definitely interesting than other coasters. Each coaster is very unique. So we're now in Universal Studios Island of Adventure. They have more themed rides, but this time the likes of Dr. Seuss, Marvel, Jurassic Park, among other things. And they even have more roller coasters here as well, and all these merch shops over here. And right over there is one of their coasters they have. It's a really big one. There's more of the coaster right up here in this view, and there it goes. That is a massive coaster. That is huge. And there's another roller coaster over there.
Chester. We're just going to blow through it, the back, and then
it's a long.
Actually, that's like a little mini train ride up there. It's not really a roller coaster, but it's pretty neat. They got some little food areas along this side. And it looks like this area is Dr. Seuss Land, which they call Seuss Landing. If you read any of the Dr. Seuss books, then you'll love this area. I got a lot of themed rides from that, including One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish, Cat in the Hat, among many others. They even have a restaurant where you can eat, and they got a carousel over there, a little play area for the minis. Oh, look at this. Green eggs and ham. How cute is that? That's pretty cool. And there's that overhead train track that takes you around the whole area. It even goes through the restaurant where you can eat at. Wow, this thing's really cool. It's not really a roller coaster, but it's built on the same steel track as a roller coaster. And it goes at a much slower pace. And there's the Zax right there. It's kind of cool. Got a lot of plants in this area too, a lot of trees growing in here. There's the tunnel where the train goes through. And here's the exit of Seuss Landing. Looks like we're going across a bridge here. Wow, look at that river. That is a big river. And there it is on the other side as well.
Does that not look like a Muppet?
Whoa, that's a big mountain right there. It's got a waterfall spewing out of it. This looks like some type of something like that, yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, that's right. Oh yeah, that is cool. Looks like there's probably a restaurant right there. Yeah, this is probably like ancient Greece or stuff like that. There's a merch shop right there. And even another restaurant right there. Treasures of Poseidon, that's what that's called. Yeah, it's definitely a Rome or Greek themed restaurant. Oh wow. It's a pretty neat area.
The Hydra's a three-headed dragon, not a four-headed snake. But I don't know much about
them. More merch shops over here on this side.
Wow. The politics.
And it looks like there's another Harry Potter themed ride, which is Hagrid's Magical Creatures Motorcycle Adventure. That's for Harry Potter, obviously. looks like we're making our way back over to the Harry Potter world for another ride. And there's Hogsmeade Station, where you can actually ride the Flying Scotsman steam locomotive train to the other side of the park. And it's really cool. It's very authentic. Like, it's the same locomotive train that Harry Potter and his friends rode in on the way to Hogwarts. And here it is, number 5972. It's basically a replica of the Flying Scotsman steam locomotive, which is one of England's most popular and powerful steam trains. So we're back in the Harry Potter world. Oh, there's Butterbeer, which you could buy there. That's pretty cool. And we're about to enter another Harry Potter themed ride. And more Island Adventure stuff will be coming momentarily. So here we're at Jurassic Park area. There's the Jeep from the movie, which is really, really cool. And here is some dinosaur themed rides and merch shops.
Wow. Not on the ride, not on
there's
the ride.
Even a dinosaur themed roller coaster too. So if you're a dinosaur fan or a fan of Jurassic Park, then you'll definitely love this area. And they got some games over here, which is really cool. They got Jurassic Park themed games. That's a basketball one, that's really cool. There's a shooter game. Wow, this one's really cool. Oh look, there's a pizza area right over there. That looks delicious. These are like some little rest areas over here. I know, that looks
right
hilarious.
On the side of this.
And it looks like there's another merch shop right over there. And it looks like that is a ride. It's called the Raptor Encounter. It's probably where you look out for velociraptors or something. And that's the River Adventure. That's like a water theme type ride where there's animatronic dinosaurs that jump out at you, and it ends with a big river splash, which to some people can be thrilling, but to me not so much, so I'm not going to do that one. Yeah, neither is my friend who's next to me. And right up there is like an overhead coaster type ride. I believe that's called the Pterodactyl. So like, you basically hang underneath there, suspended from that track. It's like you're flying, and it's really cool.
Wait, where are they?
And the track comes around, and you go up like that. It's really cool.
Wait, where are they?
Let's see. I think they're just ahead.
Oh, is that your sheet?
Signed you.
And, there's an area called Jurassic Camp. That's called the Pteranodon Flyers. That's what this track is right here. That's what you ride on with that overhead.
Can't you get that?
Yeah.
It looks kind of disgusting.
Yeah, it kind of does a little bit.
Hey, Xavier, guess what?
In your
cup that you can get.
Oh, and there's the Jurassic Park themed Ford Explorer from one of the other Jurassic Park movies. I like the green and yellow livery on here. I like the yellow rims. That one looks really, really cool. It's got to be like a 1990s model. With that Jeep. That looks beautiful. Classic. And there's Thunder Falls. That's another area where you can eat. And there's a King Kong theme right up there, which is pretty interesting, although it's not really part Jurassic Park.
I think there's a movie that came out called King Kong versus. I don't know.
That's Jurassic Park. So if you're a Jurassic Park fan, then you'll love this area. So this is SeaWorld. It's It's been a long time since I've been here. They got a lot of sea creatures and even water park themed rides here. There's even a lighthouse with its logo on it. Pretty cool. They even have a lot of games and rides as well. They even have animal interactions where they have like little areas where you can actually see some of the fish and stuff and some of the underwater aquatic life. And they do have rides here, like it looks like there's a roller coaster over there. And a lot of merch shops and gift shops. I don't remember the last time I was here, it was probably years ago, so this will be a new refresher. I can't wait to check this out. They must have probably added some stuff here after all that time. I vaguely and barely remember it, so this is definitely a new experience for me. So I'm looking forward to checking out SeaWorld, hopefully having a better memory of it this time. Can't wait to see it. It's gonna be pretty cool. So here's an outdoor aquarium. Got waterfalls here. And even live fish. And these little ponds here. It looks like there's more of it on an indoor park here. Oh, looks like it's got a new side to it. Which animals inhabit this one, but it looks pretty cool. There's a bridge on that side. There's that roller coaster again. I believe it's called the Manta. I'm not doing that one because it's a little too intense for me. Inside of the aquarium. Wow, there's a lot of fish in these tanks. Ooh, look at these. They got corals growing in there and reefs. All those fish right up there. Wow. If you're a fan of fish, then you'll love this area. Wow. Those reefs and corals look really neat. Some of those little blue ones, they kind of look like Dory a little bit. You might need to find a Dory. This looks very much like Dory. And that one. And that yellow one almost looks like Bubbles from Finding Nemo as well. There's more down that way. Check that out in a minute. A lot of these aquariums and various aquariums and stuff, which are really cool. These are full size. And even divers can go inside these aquariums for maintenance and even caring for these fish as well. It's really cool. That is really cool. You got all those fish in there. So cool. So cool that you can see them all up close like this. That's awesome. I'm guessing these are like real corals or real reefs that they probably brought in from oceans. Or some of them could be man-made. Who knows? Looks like there's another one over there. Let's see what that one is. Alright. Oh, this one is much bigger. Whoa! over top view aquarium. It's like there's workers or divers like right in there. And these are a little bit smaller fish in here. And look at that, there's a giant stingray right there. That's exactly what my car was named after. Chevrolet Corvette Stingray. That's where the name of my car came from. I can thank this thing here. Wow, that thing's massive. And those divers are right up there feeding those fish. And this is like a transparent glass that you can literally walk on. And these fish can swim over. There's no frats, no gigs, no breaks in there whatsoever. It's perfectly sealed and perfectly contained, so it doesn't puncture. It's got to be like an acrylic type of glass or something. That is so cool. Wow, looks like those divers are having really fun up there. Wow, and they can see the ground below them. We're like underground, and they're like right up there. That is so cool. Dude, that is insane. And there's a smaller stingray right there. There's a slightly bigger fish right there. I don't know if those are minnows, but those are tiny fish. Once we saw the other one right back there. Wow. That is insane. And they got bright LED lights up there as well, so the divers can see what they're doing. And whoa, I don't know what that one is, but that one's pretty big. It's gonna be like a shark. Whoa, there's that big stingray again. Look at this thing, it's huge. Ooh, that is massive. Wow. He's just hovering over us. And he's moving. You can see his mouth right there moving. Wow, he's hovering right there. That is insane. Wow. That is awesome. Oh, he's looking right at me. Look at dude, that thing is so cool. That's got to be one of the biggest stingrays I've ever seen. Diver is feeding them up there. Wow. That is insane. Yeah. More aquarium stuff to come up next. So these are sea anemones, and this one here. And there's a little starfish that's buried right behind there. I don't know if this is true, but I think clownfish can live in those anemones for protection.
Really?
I don't know, but I got that from Finding Nemo. I mean, I don't know if that's true, but I'm guessing so. Whoa, there's a giant starfish right up here. Dude, that thing is massive. Look it. And there's another anemone right there. Another anemone here. And what is that?
That
looks like an octopus right there. Kind of like Squidward from SpongeBob almost. Yeah. And that could be like, that's like Patrick right there, that thing. Kind of like that, yeah. It's awesome. And it looks like there's more stuff over here. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's in the same tank that those stingrays are in. And it looks like there's a coral reef right here. That thing's pretty cool. That thing's beautiful. And whoa, here's another big tank with other corals and stuff. And anyway, I have no idea what that thing is. That looks kind of weird looking. I don't know if those are seahorses or whatnot, but those look a little unusual. I've never seen that before. Wow. That's neat. They got artificial sand right there. That's pretty cool. Yeah, and the aquarium continues on this side. Oh. Oh, look at this. They got clownfish in this tank. Like living animals. They got tons of clownfish in this tank right here. There's a blast mix, so you could get underneath here and you could see all the action right there. It's so cool. And look at this monster size. Yeah, they got the stingrays and even the sharks and even the schools of fish inside there too. They're all moving around in this aquarium as well. Wow. Look at this.
Holes in California are like 9 to 12 feet.
If you're a fan of fish or a fan of scuba diving, then you'll love this area. Oh, that's a tiny shark right there.
And then, we went to Mexico, it's only like...
This is really cool.
Look at that. In Mexico, it's all like...
See what this is.
Horseshoe crab here?
Oh, horseshoe crab.
Well, yeah, actually, it is, but it's stinking.
There's horseshoe crabs here.
So it's hard to meet.
And there's a seahorse right down there. There's not much meat. You can see it a little bit right there.
Most of the time, they'll throw that.
So this is a dolphin show. All those divers down there are training those dolphins. And they do jumps. And they feed those dolphins. Look at that. He just jumped right there. Wow, that's so cool. Divers teach those dolphins all kinds of tricks. Look at those dolphins go. They're jumping up and down, splashing. Wow. Stand on their hind tail, and they can swim really fast and jump up to 20 feet in the air. Look at them go. Wow, that is amazing. Whoa, and they did like a synchro dive there, dude. Big splash, too. Wow, and they can do flips and loops. Look at that. Dude. Wow. That's awesome. And look, they just threw on their hind tail right there and skipped. Wow. Oh, he did like a flip right there. Dude. That's awesome. Now the divers are in the water with the dolphins, and they're playing with them, and they're communicating with them. Oh, that's so cool. Look at this. Ooh, that is insane. That's so cool that humans and dolphins can interact very well together. Wow. How cute is that? Wow. That is awesome. They're like family. Oh, look at, they're standing on their hind tails right there. Dude. Wow. That's impressive how they train these things. Wow. That is awesome. And they're dancing right there. That's pretty cool. Whoa. Dude. That's awesome. Yeah, those dolphins are pretty impressive, that's for sure. And those divers must have a lot of fun playing with them in the water. Look at that. Look at him. He's dancing on his hind tail. Look at him go. He's moving pretty quickly. Whoa, he's going around the divers like that. Look at that. Dude. Oh, wow. That's cool. Now that's impressive. Oh, and he got up there on the shore right there. Oh, and they're flipping right over there. Oh, and there's a big one that jumped right there. Oh, he jumped over there too. Whoa! That was awesome. So this is cute. They're letting a young fan on the stage feed that dolphin. That is so cute.
We're doing great, King.
And so he's feeding him, and he shook his hand and his flipper. Wow. That is a really cool opportunity. I'm guessing this dude might find a future career in SeaWorld at that one day.
Here, I'll show you how to get rid of it. Starbucks watching, so put your hands out like this and then put them together. And then you're going to rub.
That's definitely going to be a future dolphin trainer right there. I can tell.
Yeah, and then dry them off.
Wow.
It's going to be a long ride home to Illinois.
Yeah, he's from Illinois. He's visiting down here too.
And what we're going to do is we're going to see if Starbucks can come over so that you can get a chance to help me rub them down. Now, one of the things Starbucks seems to enjoy are nice, soft touches. So you can come closer, and then you can rub them on his back. Now, everyone always asks, what does a dolphin feel like? Well, their skin is super smooth.
Oh, yeah, he's going to pet him now.
What would you say he feels like? Like a dolphin. That's okay, that's a good answer.
Wow, look at
it. I'm going to show you a little secret. He has a ticklish spot. And his ticklish spot is right in front of his
feet. He has a ticklish spot. That's cute.
So, if you stand up nice and tall, good. There you go, Starbuck. Ticklish spot's right there. Oh, hang on!
Oh, he flipped.
Did he get you wet? He wet your pants. Why don't you reach in the water and you can splash him back. Go ahead, reach in there, splash him right in the face. One, two, three, splash. That's okay, Starbuck!
Oh, he got him.
We're not going to win in that game. Hey, there is one more thing I need you to do. Stand up tall. We'll see if being our junior trainer today, you learn anything. Stand in the middle, face me, but look at him. And when I say go, I want you to clap your hands together one time. Ready, set, clap. Good. He saw you.
Whoa, that was cool.
He's going to do a big jump just for you.
Whoa. Now that's a good shot right there.
He gets back here. He's here already.
Whoa, he's fast.
Hey, before you go, there's a couple of fish in the road. You can take those or toss them back in before you head home. That's it. Oh, you missed. That's okay. He'll pick it up. That's it. And what do we do with our
hands? That's awesome.
Faster.
Wow.
Can you wave goodbye to your new friend? Everybody, that's Caden. And his new friend, Starbuck.
Oh, how cute was that? That's awesome, dude. And there he goes off stage. And now they're just doing flips and celebrating and having a good time. They're also getting fed again, too. Oh, wow. Oh, and they're flipped. Look at that flip. That was... Look at him go, dude. That is a big flip right there. He's flipping all over the place. Dude. Look at how high he's going. That's cool. Look at him, he's standing on his tail! Whoa! Look at him go! That's awesome! Whoa! He went straight up there! goes.
Wow.
Oh, they all went together. Look it. Whoa. There's got to be like six of them all together. Wow. Look at that. The dolphin show is awesome. Now we're at a stingray petting zoo, which is this big tank, and they have stingrays that are right inside there, so you can touch them and you can feed them and pet them. That's so cool. There's a worker walking around right inside there, which is really cool. She hears from them too. Wow. Stingray, that's exactly the name of my car, Chevrolet Corvette Stingray. That's where it came from, so I could make this thing. Wow, and they're moving around. There's more people over there on that side. If they get real close to this edge, you can touch them, and if you got food with them with you, you can feed them. That's really cool. Oh, look, this one's coming up. There he goes, he's going over there. Wow. Some of them go in groups, whereas others can go solo. That is so cool. You can see him really good in there. Wow, got like a whole school of them. They're like deep under there. You can see him a little bit. Wow, that is cool. A few years ago, when my brother and I were on a cruise, we went to the Bahamas and we did a little excursion where we actually fed stingrays inside the ocean. Now that was really, really fun. Makes me think of that as well. Oh, that one actually flipped a little bit. That's pretty cool. Dude. Oh, these things are so cute.
Oh,
facts about these stingrays. It's pretty cool. So these are sea lions right here in this little pond right here, and there's these birds in there with them.
Yeah.
And you can actually feed them, which is really cool. Like you get seal and sea lion food from over there, and you can feed them like that.
Or you can keep it for yourself.
Yeah. And there's some more over there. And they make funny barking noises. It's hilarious, dude. And that one's just sitting there, and the others are in the pond right there. Wow. That one almost sounded like he was like growling and stuff. Yeah. And that one's just perched there on that rock. That other one too.
It's so cute.
Wow, and those birds are going at them. That looks like, I think, a crane or like a swan or something.
I think it might be an eagle.
Could be a crane. I don't know.
That one has an interesting hairstyle.
Look at its eyes. It's so cute.
Oh, and there's more over there. Where's sea lions? Okay, he just flipped right there. Those ones are getting fed.
Oh, their eyes are so cute.
And that bird is watching over them.
You know what I think the bird's doing? Because that one, whenever people are throwing them the fish, the bird's like going for it a little bit.
Yeah.
The bird is here because it's poofing fish.
And looks like that one got a piece of his food. Oh, and more food getting thrown in. Oh, and they go straight for it. Whenever they see their food, they go straight for it. It's crazy.
That's what those birds are for, dude.
Yeah. Whoa! That bird just flew so close to there. Wow. That's insane. Oh, these things are so cute.
Whoa! Oh, that scared me.
He just barked that one.
Why do you have to be so creepy?
It's so hilarious.
Look at that one's stomach though. See that one? It's very red.
Oh yeah, yeah, I do see that.
Maybe he's sunburned.
They look kind of upset.
And there's more right down there.
That one sounds like it was sneezing.
That one thinks Jack was Titanic. He thinks he's on top of the world.
I'm on top of the world, eh?
And there's that one over there. He just dove in.
He's walking. I'm on top. Oh,
and that bird flew over here again. Same bird, yeah. That one just barked.
These ones are over here, like, where's my food? You see them? They're just
desperate for food, some of these guys.
Staring at everyone.
Yeah. The way these guys bark is just so cute and hilarious and funny.
Oh my god!
Wow, and that one just got some food. And there's that bird again! Whoa, this is interesting. This is hilarious.
Why are those animals called again?
Which ones?
Those animals.
Is that the bird? Or the...
Yeah, why are they called again?
I'm guessing they're...
Ha ha ha!
I could stay here and watch him bark all day. That's so funny.
They're
kind of fighting. He just pushed him in the pond. Oh, dude, I'm getting a kick out of this. I love these dudes. You're so funny. They're just desperate for food. He's got a weird barking sound, that one. Dude. Oh, dude. Oh, these seals and sea lions. Dude, they are just so cute and hilarious and funny. Oh. Oh, dude. Oh, and there's more right there.
Ew!
Ew!
Oh my god!
That made a weird noise. Sounds like it's burping or something, or belching next to barking. I don't even know, but that sounded so weird. I'm really enjoying this. Dude. Wow, how cute is this, dude? Oh. Oh, that bird just caught that food in midair. Dude, that was awesome.
You're so stupid.
These animals are skilled, aren't they, Steve? They got some skills.
Just the way they sound is just so cute and funny.
It's so adorable, yet so hilarious.
I'm getting a kick out of this. I totally am. This is, like, I think, one of my new favorite areas in all of SeaWorld. Oh, that one sounded weird.
Oh, he's doing a back. Bruh.
Oh, you're gonna feed him? Okay. Oh, he got it. Wow, look at them. They're so accurate when they catch that food. Dude, look it.
He stole it.
Oh, wow. This is hilarious. These have gotta be the funniest animals I've ever filmed. Wow.
Oh my god!
Wow.
Dude! Why? Oh my god!
Oh, that one's barking up the storm. Wow. Oh, wow. He's watching him!
Hey,
he got that one.
Oh,
wow. Oh, I'm really enjoying this. This is hilarious.
Yeah. I dare you, keep our own.
Wow. Those are super funny.
They're in the wild too. They'll just like bark at each other like about
yeah,
food.
I heard so
a
hilarious.
A seal just said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, looks like that one just flipped. Stay. Wow. I'm guessing they're trying to show off. Look at that one just dove in.
See that one. That one. Just, look at that
little
one.
That's interesting.
See that one?
Yeah. Whoa! That one jumped up. Now these ones are still waiting for food. They are desperate for more food. Wow. This is hilarious.
She said they've never had, they're never getting fed, but they do. She said they know what they're doing.
They're begging consistently.
Yeah, she said that they know what they're doing.
They just do. It's crazy.
Yeah. I want to take that one.
I'm really enjoying this. This is awesome. This is hilarious.
Like the boats just flying on their own.
Yeah.
We fish.
They just do.
Yeah.
I love these dudes so much. They're the best.
I love CY.
Oh, look at this. There's Cookie Monster. You can take a picture with him. Photos with Elmo and friends. Wow, that's cute. Wow. Oh, wow. There's some of the photos of Grover, Cookie Monster, and Oscar right here.
There's a water fountain.
Oh, and it looks like here's a mini train ride right over here with the minis. Oh, look at this. Dude, this thing is so cool. It goes around this railroad track. It's so cool, dude. It's like a scaled down replica steam engine. That is so cool. Oh, and they got food trucks right over here too. That's pretty neat. Wow. I'm surprised that they have Sesame Street and SeaWorld. That's insane. Oh, and this looks like a little playground area. Also for the minis. Wow. Yeah, it is a playground for the minis. Wow, that's like a golf course, kinda, with the terrain. Oh, and they got a... I'm guessing that's a ride or a test your strength thing? I don't know. That looks like a Big Bird ride. Ah, Big Bird's Twirling World. I think we might do this one. This looks pretty cool. It's a mini ride, but hey, we can do it too. And here's... Alright, so that's the end of our Universal SeaWorld trip. We all had a great time. Everyone did great. It was a lot of fun. We did a lot of games and rides and walked around a lot. It was a lot of fun. And we're going to be heading back home to Atlanta tomorrow. And this concludes our trip to SeaWorld and Universal Studios. Never mind.